we're asked to apply the distributive property. And we have 1/2 times the expression 2a minus 6b plus 8. So to figure this out, I've actually already copy and pasted this problem onto my scratch pad. I have it right over here. 1/2 times 2a minus 6b plus 8. Actually, let me just rewrite it. So I'm going to take, and let me color code it too, just for fun. So this is going to be 1/2 times, give myself some space, 1/2 times 2a minus 6b. So 2a minus 6b minus 6, let me write it this way, minus 6b, and then we have plus 8. Plus, and I will do 8 in this color, plus 8. And so I just need to distribute the 1/2. If I'm multiplying 1/2 times this entire expression, that means I multiply 1/2 times each of these terms. So I'm going to multiply 1/2 times this, 1/2 times this, and 1/2 times that. So 1/2 times 2a, so it's going to be 1/2 times 2a times, let me do that same color so you see where the 2a came from. 1/2 times 2a minus 1/2 times 6b minus 1/2 times 6b times 6b plus 1/2 times 8. 1/2 times 8. And so what's this going to be? Well, let's see, I have 1/2 times 2a. 1/2 times 2 is just 1, so you're just going to be left with a. And then you have minus 1/2 times 6b. Well, we could just think about what 1/2 times 6 is going to be. 1/2 times 6 is going to be 3, and then you still are multiplying times b. So it's going to be 3b. And then we have plus 1/2 times 8. Half of 8 is 4. Or as you can say, 8 halves is equal to 4 wholes. All right, so this is going to be 4. So it's a minus 3b plus 4. A minus 3b plus 4. So let's type that in. It's going to be a minus 3b plus 4. And notice, it's literally half of each of these terms. Half of 2a is a, half of 6b is 3b. So we have minus 6b, so it's going to be minus 3b. And then plus 8, instead of that, half of that, plus 4. So let's check our answer. And we got it right. Let's do another one of these. So let's say, apply the distributive property to factor out the greatest common factor. And here we have 60m minus 40. So let me get my scratch pad out again. So I'm running out of space that way. So we have, all right, like this. We have 60m minus 40. Minus 40. So what is the greatest common factor of 60m and 40? Well, 10 might jump out at us. We might say, okay, look, you know, 60 is 10. So we could say that this is the same thing as 10 times 6. And actually, and then of course you have the m there. So you could view this as 10 times 6m. And then you could view this as 10 times 4. But 10 still isn't the greatest common factor. And you say, well, Sal, how do you know that? Well, because 4 and 6 still share a factor in common. They still share 2. So if you're actually factoring out the greatest common factor, what's left should not share a factor with each other. So let me think even harder about what a greatest common factor of 60 and 40 is. Well, 2 times 10 is 20. So you could actually factor out a 20. So you have 20 and 20 and 3m, and 40 can be factored out into 20 and 20 and 2. And now 3m and 2 share no common factor, so you know that you have fully factored these two things out. Now if you think that this is something kind of a strange art that I just did, one way to think about greatest common factors, you say, okay, 60, you can literally do a prime factorization. You say 60 is 2 times 30, which is 2 times 15, which is 3 times 5. So that's 60's prime factorization, 2 times 2 times 3 times 5. And then 40's prime factorization is 2 times 20. 20 is 2 times 10. 10 is 2 times 5. So that right over here, this is 40's prime factorization. And to get out the greatest common factor, you want to get out as many common prime factors. So you have here, you have two twos and a five. Here you have two twos and a five. You can't go to three twos and a five because there aren't three twos and a five over here. So you have two twos and a five here, two twos and a five here. So 2 times 2 times 5 is going to be the greatest common factor. So 2 times 2 times 5, that's 4 times 5. 4 times 5, that is 20. That's one way of kind of very systematically figuring out a greatest common factor. But anyway, now that we know that 20 is the greatest common factor, let's factor it out. So this is going to be equal to 20 times, so 60m divided by 20, you're just going to be left with 3m. Just going to be left with 3m. And then minus 40 divided by 20, you're just left with the 2. Minus 2. So let's type that in. So this is going to be 20 times 3m, 3m minus 2. And once again, we feel good that we did take out the greatest common factor, because 3m and 2, especially 3 and 2, are now relatively prime. Relatively prime just means they don't share any factors in common other than 1.